What challenges are facing the energy sector? And how can digital twins be used to solve these problems? I'm Asma from Ansys, and you're watching the Twin Talks. To answer these questions, we are joined today by Mark Bate. Mark is a senior product sales manager here at Ansys with over 30 years experience across a range of industry verticals. He works with organizations across EMEA to help them to develop their use of Ansys software to create hybrid digital twins, to identify and drive significant business value across the whole of the product and asset lifecycle, from design and optimization through operations and asset maintenance. Thanks for being part of this Twin Talk, Mark.
Thanks, Asma. It's a pleasure to be speaking with you today on this.
Mark, what are some of the biggest challenges currently faced in the energy and sustainability sectors?
Yeah, of course, there's many to speak of, but two that we see common across all industries are challenges related to sustainability and digital transformation. There's an ever increasing regulatory compliance on companies, you know, with regards to sustainability and reducing CO2 emissions. Ever increasing competition from other businesses who are adopting digital transformation technologies. You know, they're doing more with the data that they have. And also, there's internal pressure from the business itself to continuously improve productivity and reduce operations and maintenance costs. And people are being asked to do more in less time and with less resource. Traditional monitoring of assets and process with data alone is not always enough to make a step change improvement to some of the issues that the energy sector is facing. But what we are seeing is those companies that are adopting a sort of joint approach with data and physics together to create hybrid digital twins are making the quickest and most significant improvements.
How can hybrid digital twins help address these issues?
Yeah, so especially in thermally intensive industries, you know, like power, oil and gas, glass, rubber, steel, and so on, most of these will already have some kind of sustainability program as a key business initiative, you know, to reduce carbon emissions, and also have plans, as I said, to continuously improve asset and operational efficiency. Using physics simulation and data, you can create hybrid digital twins to predict things and measure things that you're not able to do now. So you can make significant improvements on how you operate and maintain your assets above and beyond what is capable today. And when we talk about your sort of predictive maintenance, machine learning digital twins have been around for a long time. You know, they're not new. And they do provide capability to give early detection of a range of sort of common failure modes and known issues, but still problems can persist, and that's usually due to sort of data and knowledge. The models themselves from a machine learning approach they're limited to working only with the data, the sensor data that's available, and the historical subset of data that's available for training the models. So they don't always do too well with identifying a new issue that's coming up, something it hasn't seen in the data before. You know, they don't do too well with the what-if scenarios. You know, you can't sort of you can't predict what's going to happen. You know, for something that's unknown outside of the data. And if there's limited data, then not all failure modes are going to be covered. By adding simulation, we can create additional virtual sensors to measure missing or incomplete data, adding greater capability to those existing machine learning models and improving strategies for predictive maintenance. And I think what simulation allows us to do is take data that we can measure from the asset, and through the understanding of the physics of the asset or the process, we can predict that data in areas that we can't always measure or don't necessarily want to measure or install the physical sensors. Many applications in heavy industry involve extreme environments where, you know, placing a regular physical sensor is challenging or not even possible. So use of virtual sensors can be very useful and be used for improving predictive analytics capability, used for process optimization, or to maximize yield and plant output. And as I touched on there a little bit, doing the what-if scenarios, you know, there's some limitations there with a machine learning only approach. So by using simulation, we can do the what-if scenarios. So if you want to understand what running 10% above your normal operating threshold, you know, what effect that's going to have on your assets or your process, it's difficult to do that with a data approach only, because essentially you would have to run the plant or the run the assets or the plant in that sort of new condition to understand how it will be, how it will behave, how it will affect the unit, and so on. Whereas with simulation, you can sort of do these scenarios offline. You can run these scenarios to understand how a particular change will make an impact on the site. So there's some real benefits for having the two approaches together.
And Mark, can you share a real-world example of how Ansys Digital Twins have been used to solve a critical problem in the energy sector?
Yeah, so over the past few years, we've been working with Tata Steel in the Netherlands. So they use these huge torpedoes, around sort of 20 torpedoes, to move molten metal across the site. And the most efficient way of sort of doing this in terms of the process is to have higher molten metal temperatures, but this leads to increased wear and higher energy usage overall in the system. So there's a balance to be achieved to sort of maximise, you know, the process and to keep the maintenance costs and energy costs down. So they have been using a sort of trial and error approach with data only, but it wasn't really efficient, and they were already using simulation for part of their operations. So they developed an approach where they created some hybrid digital twins and created a sort of a digital twin of the whole process. And then the hybrid digital twin was developed to optimize wear and energy consumption. So that's being sort of rolled out at the site now. They're in the sort of a deployment phase now. But what they are seeing is there's downtime is reduced by hundreds of hours. They've been able to optimize the number of torpedoes in use at any one time, which massively reduces the energy costs as well. So this is helping them. As I said, you know, companies have these sustainability targets and maintenance targets, and this is helping greatly with Tata Steel. They have a target of reaching 30 to 40% energy, reduction in emissions by 2030, and this is a significant way to help them achieve that.
What recent advancements in digital twin technology have had the most significant impact on energy and sustainability projects?
Yeah, I'd say because of the developments that have been going on in physics simulation, and especially around reduced order modeling and deployment of digital twins, simulation-based digital twins, it means it's now possible to utilize these high-fidelity physics simulation models and data together in real time to improve operations and maintenance activities. It allows us to now create these highly accurate hybrid digital twins that help you do more with the data that you already have. And as in the Tata Steel example I just mentioned, you know, it's that specific combination of physics simulation and data together that enable these outcomes. You know, the results are not achievable with asset data alone.
Looking ahead, how do you see the role of digital twins evolving in the energy sector, and what new opportunities might arise from their continued development?
Yeah, I mean, one thing's for sure, you know, hybrid digital twins, the use of hybrid digital twins is only going to sort of accelerate and become more adopted. And especially as more use cases are developed and business value is verified, more businesses will have to adopt these approaches to remain competitive. You know, those that don't will be finding themselves in a very difficult position to try and catch up. You know, as we touched on, creating virtual sensors, carrying out what-if scenarios are two of the main benefits that this approach can bring and provides value. So anywhere this does provide value is an area for growth, But I think, you know, one key area we see where businesses may be already using simulation for designing assets or plant processes. These are highly accurate, high fidelity models that you know can be repurposed in an operations context. So you can deploy them in an actual real context and calibrate these high fidelity as physics simulation models with real data from the asset. So when you think about OEMs who sort of you know run the whole process from sort of cradle to grave for their assets, you know, they design them, they manufacture them, they install and provide O&M services for their products. You know, it really makes sense for these, and we're seeing these companies adopting making use of their high fidelity models from the design phase to create these hybrid digital twins that serve not only to understand how best to optimize operations and maintenance activities, but also provide a feedback loop to original design models to improve the next sort of next generation of products.
Thank you so much, Mark, for being part of this new episode of the Twin Talks.
Okay, thanks, Asma. Thank you.